trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, the clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
This is your last chance. Come on, come on, come on.
The colors of the rainbow.
I warned you.
So pretty in the sky are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying,
come on, you stupid beast. Fantastic. Ken! Ken! What have I told you a million times?
Do not cuddle the chickens.
No.
Stay away from the ballet school?
No.
Never point at the tea towel.
Look at this. Tea towel on left and towel on right. Stupid Dalek. Oh, my good gracious, Ken, look.
What?
Lo, a rainbow has formed over the land. Water, air and earth in perfect harmony, bathing in miles and miles of lush green countryside. That is Sunnyside Farm. And I really shagginate it.
Well, I think it's lovely.
Please, Ken, please, let's sell the farm, please.
Oh, sell, 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 that's all you ever say. Well, we're not. When Mum left us the farm, she said we should care for it and neuter it.
It was nurture, actually. The thing about Mum was, she was mental.
Well, I think it's lovely.
And which is your favourite part of this rural ideal?
The cows.
Really? Then I suggest you go and clean the shit out their barn.
I was going to tell you about them. Are you in a good mood?
You stupid banjo. What you done with them? I'll make it easy for you. Are the cows in the fields?
No.
Are the cows in the barn?
No. They were looking at me funny. I got scared.
You've killed them, haven't you?
No. I lost them.
You lost them?
I lost them.
How the hell can you lose 15 dirty great half-ton cows?
I put them on a bus.
A bus?
A bus.
Now tell me what happened. Everything. Think carefully.
It was me and the cows. Then a bus. Then some pushing and shouting. Then the bus drove off quickly with the cows and it was just me. Then it started raining and I come home. Then you asked me about the cows and I couldn't remember. And then it was now.
Ken, you are a towering tit. Now go and get me bloody cows or I'll kill you with a gun.
Fair dues.
Excuse me.
Hello, my lovers. Isn't it grand to be alive on such a God-given day as this, eh?
Oh, yes, yes, lovely. I wonder if you could help us. We seem to be directionally impaired.
We're lost. We're looking for Honeysuckle Cottage.
Oh, you're the people who bought it?
That's right.
You want to go down the end there, up the hill, and it's on the right.
Thanks very much.
And if you ever need anything, any veggie or milk, just give me a shout. Ask for Mr. Mills. Everyone round here knows me.
Oh, Oh, that's very kind of you. We'll bear it in mind.
What a lovely man.
Well, I'd best be off myself. We've had reports of some nut around here exposing himself to people. So, you keep an eye out and let me know if you see anything strange. All right?
Will do. Bye-bye for now.
Riding six white horses when she comes.
She'll be riding six white horses when she comes.
Is that Wayfarer Bus's lost property? I was wondering if anyone's handed in some cows. Yes, cows! 15. What do you mean you'll have to check? Godley and Cream! Oi! This is private property! Get out of it! Are you deaf, you lumpy great sack of shit? Oh, Mr. Letchworth, it's you. And how are you this fine morning?
Mr. Sunnyside, what an absolute delight to see you. Now, don't tell me, is that Armani you're wearing? Or is it my yaki?
Nah, it's in my trousers.
Well, yes, of course it is. How thunderously stupid of me.
How can I help you, Mr. Letchworth?
Well, I was just driving along here, you know, and I thought, well, now, wouldn't it be just the most delightful thing to pop in and see Mr. Sunnyside, and while I'm there, perhaps ask him if he has any intention of paying me back the money he owes me, or whether he'd rather be shredded by a plum?
Oh, yeah, Mr. Letchworth, I cannot tell a lie. Because I can't think of one at the moment. But don't worry, I shall come up with a plan.
Well, I already have. It's a rather devilish one. Slaughter all your cows and give me the cash.
Yeah, yeah. Bit of a cow flow problem at the moment. But fear not, my good brother Kenneth is bang on to it by now.
No, your good brother Kenneth should be banged up by now.
Oh, no. I couldn't do that on my own, bro. Hang on. Yes, I could, yeah. Yeah. He put cows on a bus. I'll get him banged up in a nut hatch.
Yeah, I think you've mentioned getting rid of old Ken before, but you haven't, have you?
Yeah, but this time it's different. I'll get someone to give me a legally binding document saying, I hereby declare that Ken is completely Looney Tunes, signed a doctor. And with him out of the way, I'll sell the farm, move to the city, get a big gaff like yours, full of posh birds, and...
Yeah, I do remember all your little pipe dreams, Mr. Sunnyside. You just better hurry up with
couple
it.
Couple of weeks, max.
Oh, dear. Lose 5 points for an incorrect interruption. 1 week, max, or it's...
What are you doing?
Waving goodbye to your kneecaps. And can I just point out that I don't, of course, need the money.
Well, no, no, of course you don't.
But I would still like it nonetheless.
Well, yeah, yeah, of course you would. Everybody
don't
would.
Don't grovel, Mr. Sunnyside. It doesn't suit you. Well, actually, it does suit you, but I'd still rather you didn't do it.
Let me open the gate for you.
There's no need.
Please, I insist.
There's really no need.
House. That must be where the neighbours live. Isn't it simply a picture?
Ah, the rough-hewn seat of nature's true denizens.
Can you see the lovely farmhouse, children? Expect the farmer settling back into his favourite armchair with his faithful dog by his side.
What? New what? New neighbours? I don't give a donkey's jockstrap about that. I just want to... What? A woman? Round here! Right, one word at a time! Age?
Young.
Hair?
Blonde.
Breasts?
Hey? Eh?
Zip, zip!
Oh, pert.
Oh. Legs?
Yes.
No, I meant... Never mind. The rustic, sexy farmer. Bit of rough for a rhinus. Just moved in round here, have you? Mmm. Kaz! Every blood is irresistible. You stupid gherkin. When looking for cows, confine your search to cow-sized spaces or larger. All right? I'm off to do a spot of lady killing.
Morning!
Hello.
Bloody hell!
You must be Mr. Sunnyside. My name's Wendy. How do you do?
Can I touch it?
We were just saying what a beautiful farmhouse you live in.
Oh, you're blind. Didn't realise.
I do love your rustic sense of humour.
I was here first, mate. Bog off!
This is my husband, Justin.
Hello.
And these are our children. Say hello to Mr. Sunnyside, children.
Hello.
Your kids?
Yes.
By him?
Yes.
Well, that means he's... Well, that's not fair.
Come on, children, let's get some elderflower juice for Daddy and Mr. Sunnyside.
Mummy?
Yes, darling?
Mr. Sunnyside smells of poo.
Well, he is a farmer, darling.
He's a smelly farmer.
Lovely wife you got there.
Thank you.
Only, no offence, mate, but to look at you, you'd have thought your wife would be a right old dyke. But, she could be in a Sunday sport. Nice place you got here. You must be loaded, eh?
Well, I am a senior financial advisor.
Here we are, then. Listen, why don't you come over tomorrow night and help us settle in? You could bring your partner if you like.
Sounds divine, Wendy. I'll, just check my dairy.
You mean your diary?
No, me dairy. Don't look like them cows has come home yet.
What?
Our Sunnyside Farm runs an organic policy where we let our cows roam the fields free and happy.
Oh, that's just so lovely.
I thought you'd think that. It's been a delight to meet you, Wendy. Until tomorrow night.
Until tomorrow.
Yes. Another perfect day working the soil that is Sunnyside Farm. 40 acres of hopelessness and shit. And most of it stuck to me.
I never seem to get dirty.
It's funny, really.
That is a top chuckle, Ken. Not quite the Bew Brummel I wish to show Wendy. A little tinkering required. Ah. Here we are. Pops Mr. Sex. Jarvis Cocker. Turns the girls to pulp. And not just the common people. He looks like a specky tit to me. But who am I, eh? Let the world get ready for Farmer Cocker.
Oberon, have you finished making the dandelion donkey for Mr. Sunnyside yet?
No, he's burning some worms with a magnifying glass.
Oh, it's great, isn't it? New friends, new life. It's so exciting.
Darling, tie or bow tie?
Neither. We're not in the city now. Anyway, I'm sure the Sunnysides aren't bothering with any superficial frippery.
Oh, yes! Get a load of him! Just need me Uncle Jimmy's old specs. Raimondo, baby, you are a sen-bloody-sation. Well, Ken.
What?
This.
What?
This.
What?
Stop getting angry for no reason.
Well, shut your neck. Get upstairs. Put something nice on.
Oh, that.
Yeah.
You look like a tosspot.
Full of style. On your knees, cocker.
Raymond, I... Jesus Christ.
I like to make an effort. I've got a date with that Wendy. I think she's lovely, don't you?
No.
I think she's a stupid, simpering, upper-middle-class, blonde, bimboid city girl who deserves a gigantic kick up her pampered backside.
Yeah, apart from that, though, she's lovely, isn't she? I mean, you're right, but...
You shut your face.
Yep, fair comment.
Now, I just thought I should apologise about your gate.
Ah, that's all right. Me and Ken spent last night fixing it.
No, I mean, I've just done it again.
Well, these things happen, don't they?
Yes, and they have the habit of happening more and more to people who don't pay their debts.
Oh, yeah, that.
Yes, Mr. Sunnyside, that. Remember, you have until lunchtime tomorrow.
You said a week.
Yes, but I've changed my mind.
But why?
Well, I would have thought that was perfectly obvious, because I'm a bastard. Goodbye. Till lunchtime tomorrow.
Cat flaps! Must get Ken packed off to the nuthatch. Hello? Doctor? It's Ray Sunnyside here. Eh? You want me a what off? No, really, it's Ken. He's a nutter. I want you to come round here and pronounce him officially barking. He's been putting cows on buses. He bloody has. What the f... And now he's dressed as Dame Sybil Thorndyke and wearing tornado red lippy. Tomorrow at one, lovely. Ken, what in the name of all that is holy are you up to?
You said to put on something nice.
Well, take it off, now!
You should give me flowers first.
Go upstairs, put on something proper.
This is proper. Don't be nasty to me.
Ken, please believe me when I tell you, brother to brother, that you look like a breeze block in drag. But if you insist on going over there looking ghastly, well, then it's up to you.
Ah, thanks.
Now, social etiquette. If during the course of the evening I say something witty or amusing or cut down my opposite number with a rapier-like riposte, you are to throw your head back and laughingly say, touché!
Touché!
Indeed. At the end of the evening, I intend to make a speech. When you hear me say speech, you are to say speech, speech. Do you understand? And if they ask you anything...
Yeah?
We're buggered.
Mummy, it's Dracula and a woman.
Oh, it's not a fancy dress.
Well, stuff you, it's the fanciest dress I could find.
You must forgive my brother Kenneth's unfortunate remark, only you see, he is a buck.
Well, pleased to meet you, Kenneth. Please, have a seat.
Oh, it's not a fancy dress.
Right, that's it. Sit down, you stupid paddle. Now, Wendy, why don't you come and have a sparkling and witty conversation with me?
I end up getting some grief from these mules.
You might have a corn there. You should let me have a look. I used to be a nurse.
Did you? Did you really? With a sky blue and white uniform, with a red cross in the middle and a little linen hat and a watch on your tit. I mean about here, upside down and clingy white tights and shiny black shoes.
No, no, it was maroon.
Oh, well, I hope you kept it. Because then you could have put it on for one of those, you know, things where people get dressed up and sort of march up and down a bit.
Not a fancy dress.
Say that again and I'll lamp you.
A pageant.
Ah, yeah, a country pageant. If you fancy dressing up, there's one of them tomorrow, funnily enough.
Is there? I've never heard of it.
Haven't you, Kenneth? Well, that is, I imagine, because the parts of your brain that process information have not worked since about 1973.
Touché!
Well, it sounds rather exciting.
Sorry. No blokes allowed, you see. You see, the tradition of the old country pageantry piss-up is when newcomers arrive... The squire of the land, well, that's me, invites just the bird over to his house, welcomes her formally to the parish and the pork, sir.
Drink round.
Oh, I shouldn't really. Got important family business tomorrow. Go on, then. Special occasion, innit? May I raise a toast to rural tranquility and pleasant company? Cheers!
Cheers.
Balls! Touché!
Balls!
Touché!
Balls is what I'm saying, Justin! Cause it's balls is what you're talking!
All right. All right. Maybe Daffy Duck is harder than Porky Pig. I really don't have a strong opinion about it.
Oh, sorry for that small outburst. I hope I haven't spoilt the ambience of the evening. Justin, let us agree to disagree and drink a drink to your wife's very good legs. Cheers!
Yes, cheers.
So, do you feel you'll become accustomed to the country and settle in the area?
We'd love to.
Shut up, you insect. Wendy.
We'd love to.
Would you, Wendy? I'd love you too. Cheers!
Mummy, I can't get to sleep because of a man shouting cheers and balls.
Dear darling, I'll be up in a minute.
How dare you speak your mother like that? Good might take my belt with that one, aren't I?
Touché!
do excuse me. I'm most apologetic. Whoops! Seem to be slurring my speech.
Speech! Speech!
Oh, yeah, okay.
To some extent,
shush,
really?
Or I'll belt you. Ladies and gentlemen, my feelings at the moment are too deep and complex to express in mere words. Much better, I feel, to express in song.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Wendy. Well, you came and I saw and I met you. I'd take you away. Oh, Wendy! Well, it's all...
I've wet myself.
I think it went rather well, actually.
Yeah, especially after you spent 2 hours saying sorry, sorry, sorry and begging her to still come as a nurse to your made-up pageant.
Yeah, all right. A minor blemish on an otherwise spotless social soiree. Kenneth, my good man, you go home and prepare the bed linen. For my part, I intend to urinate heavily upon this bush. Oh, there we go. Better in than that. Better than in, huh? Wait! Come back here!
Morning, Ray. Sleep well?
Would you kindly inform whoever is a-banging at the door? If they do not desist promptly, I shall kick their lungs out.
It's the doctor.
The doctor, what the friggin' help? Oh! Ladies knockers! Oh! Perfect. Ray Sunnyside, your golden destiny awaits.
Morty. What, I wondered, is the problem this time?
It's Ken.
Oh, I see.
He's a nutter, and he's locking up.
Mr. Sunnyside, your brother is a slightly eccentric, but ultimately harmless man.
Oh, yeah? Take a seat and get your lock-em-up forms at the ready. Pray, Kenneth, tell the doctor what you did with the cows.
What cows?
The cows on a bus.
A bus?
Bus.
Cows on a bus?
There was you and the cars, and then you and the bus. Remember?
Ray?
What?
You're weird.
Right, that's it.
Please, Doctor, I'm begging you. You've got to lock him up, eh?
Right, all set. So where's the pageant?
Oh, yeah.
Pageant? You're new around here.
Yes.
Yeah, well, knowing Ray, I would imagine that the pageant is some sort of excuse so that he can see you in a nurse's uniform.
Is this true?
Superficially, yeah.
And I am here because he has just tried to have his brother locked up in a mental hospital.
What? McKinsey?
Don't listen to him! He's a Martian that's taken on human form!
Piss off, Ray, you dismal oaf.
Hey, look, Doctor, you can't go. You can't go. You're my saviour. Oh, Wendy, dear.
I can't believe what you just tried to do to Ken. I mean, this is one thing, but to do that to your own brother? Oh, you disgust me.
But Wendy, I love my brother.
Oh, the cows. I'll put them on a bus.
Right!
No, stop it! Stop it!
What?
Oh, chocolate horses!
Cooey! Ah, another fine day on Sunnyside Farm. How are you feeling, Raymond?
I've failed. I haven't got your money. So if you're going to batter me, get on with it.
Now, I got some very good news for you. Come outside.
Unless it's the bird from Echo Belly with a bag of coke, I shall be staying put. Thank you very much.
Raymond, do get up or I shall dissect you.
Fair comment, Mr. Letchworth.
Thank you.
But bloody Bacharach! It's me Christ in cow! Fan-twat-intastic! Now I can slaughter them!
And pay off all your debts?
Yep.
Slaughter them? No! Don't do that, Raymond! Let them live and run free in your organic fields!
Okay, how about if we let half of them run free in the organic fields and we slaughter the rest of them?
All or nothing, I'm afraid, Raymond. Cows or knees. What's it to be?
Set them free.
Slaughter.
What are you going to do, Ray?
I'm pleased to announce that I have worked out a perfect solution to this, apparently intractable problem. And who better to tell you about it than my good brother Ken?
Yeah. Hey?
BBC Two's Back Amidst the Manure next week at the same time, 9:30. Next tonight, Rab thinks he's got it all. A mistake, surely.